लाइक भारत।
यस हेलो हेलो गुड इवनिंग गाइस। या इफ यू कैन हियर माय वॉइस जस्ट टाइप परफेक्ट ऑन द चैट बॉक्स। परफेक्ट परफेक्ट। सो या गुड इवनिंग, वेलकम टू द मास्टर क्लास वेबिनार ऑन इंडस्ट्री 4.0। माई सेल्फ भरत, आई एम ए डिजिटल मार्केटर लुकिंग टू मेक ए चेंज इन दिस डिजिटल वर्ल्ड। यस, सो आई रियली अप्रिशिएट द फैक्ट दैट एट दिस पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम यू माइट बी चिलिंग आउट ऑन नेटफ्लिक्स प्राइम और एंगेज विथ एनी ऑफ योर वर्क, बट वी अप्रिशिएट द फैक्ट दैट यू पीपल हैव अटेंडेड दिस वेबिनार टू गेन सम नॉलेज। सो वी अश्योर यू दैट यू आर गोइंग टू वर्क आउट, दैट यू हैव लर्न समथिंग न्यू फ्रॉम दिस वेबिनार। सो हाउ मनी ऑफ यू आर अमेज्ड विद द टेक्नोलॉजी इन द करेंट सिनेरियो? आई मीन बिकॉज दिस सी एज वी कैन सी द होल वर्ल्ड इज लॉक डाउन, ऑलमोस्ट ऑल मेजर पार्ट्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड इज लॉक डाउन, एंड द टेक्नोलॉजी हैज गिवन अस ए ब्यूटिफुल प्लेटफॉर्म टू गेट ऑल दिस डेलीगेट्स टूगेदर। एंड सो here itself we can understand the technology is evolving day by day, and we need to use it in a proper way to gain our experience and knowledge. So let's get back to the session without wasting much of your time. With your permission, do I have a with your permission, do I have a privilege to share about ourselves? So just type yes if we want to share about ourselves. Yes, awesome, fantastic guys. Keep up pumping us with the comments on the chat box because that is like oxygen to us. So the more comments you comment on it, we get more motivated by your comments. Yes, I would like to hello. Yeah, I would like to introduce our panel experts who are going to speak on this session, on this webinar day. So firstly, I would like to introduce Mr. Gangadhar Boparna. So he's an entrepreneur and a business analyst. So he has been in the automation industry from past 13 plus years. So he has also been an recently ISB alumni, so where he has pursued advanced management in business analytics. So coming to our guest speakers, so we have Nigel Vijayan today. So he's a employee from Phoenix Contacts. So he's our guest speaker. So he's going to share the knowledge about PLC. And so as I've already introduced myself, I am Bharat. So I will be coordinating you for the next 90 minutes of this webinar. And yeah, coming to Mr. Suman Apuri. So Mr. Subban Apuri is also an industrial automation expert, having 13 plus years of tremendous experience, where he has executed more than 200 unique projects out of his service. So isn't this amazing, guys? So the motto of our session today is to give a taste of Industry 4.0, because we need to admit the fact that knowing the world where it is going is really important. And more than that, awareness is more important than intelligence, and taking action is more important than awareness. So let's just start it with the session. So these are the learnings and takeaways which we are going to share our knowledge and experience in regards to Industry 4.0. So firstly, so these are the this is the agenda of and key takeaways from this session. So we'll be running you all through. So we have decided, we have seen the participants coming from different fields and different designations. So We tried as much as we could to make this presentation as simple as it is to all the people, even if even a non-technical, even a person from non-technical background can easily comprehend with this webinar. So yeah, so the, you are going to we are going to run you through the latest industry 4.0 trends and technologies, architectures and challenges, real-time. Go ahead. Yeah, yes, it was sorry for the inconvenience. So we are going to run you through the latest trends and technologies, architecture and real-time case studies and demos, which you're going to enjoy for sure, because we have working on something new which is going to hit the market. Yeah, so and also you can enhance your technical skills with advanced technology. And also, like, if there, I think I've seen few aspirants who are building up their careers recently, so this would be a perfect webinar for them to be competitive in job market as well. So hang on, guys, there's something more than this. So we are going to distribute an ebook where the, all the basics terminologies of Industry 4.0 is covered. And you can have a good taste of Industry 4.0 if you want to explore this industry. And next, we have a demo on social distancing as well. So it is a latest, I mean, so we are working on this tool right now. So we would like to give a small glimpse about this tool as well. Yeah. So it was a great opportunity for me to host all the delegates on one platform. So this is just possible by technology. Yeah, and also, so based on our recent, I mean, surveys and recent market research and considering many factors, we have decided to conduct and share our knowledge on Industry 4.0 and Internet of Things. So this is the next webinar, which actually we were supposed to host it on April 13th, but due to unavoidable circumstances, we have postponed it to May 2nd. So I hope you all to see you there, and it's going to be a wonderful session as well. And you also have a good goodie at the end of session for Internet of Things as well. Yeah. So without wasting much of your time, let me introduce to our first speaker, Mr. Gangadhar. I would like you to take the stage.
Sure. Thanks, Bharat. Thanks for giving an opportunity to speak about Industry 4.0.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
So guys, I think this is a four-pack section. I can guarantee you, you can able to learn good terminologies, good technologies, and what is going to be the future. So are you amazing? So if you can able to view my you can able to view me and you can able to audible my voice, please type in S in your chat window.
Yes, we are able to hear you.
Sure. Thank you. Thank you, guys. So let me start. So I'll take into the some level of analysis where before starting into the Industry 4.0, this is the agenda. So we would like to introduce about our company. Then we would like to tell about Industry 4.0 and digital manufacturing technologies, the more into the RAMI architecture and IT/OT connectivity, interoperability challenges and addressing interoperability challenges, advantage of Industry 4.0. And there will be in a power pack case studies and demonstrations for guys. You are going to see how the Industry 4.0 really implemented in automotive industry. Our team has extensively worked from the past few years and executed the few projects in automotive industry. So you can able to go through the real-time case studies, how it is implemented practically. So there are a lot of participants from automotive sector and different industry sector. And there is a guest speaker who are going to explain about the PLC next technology. It's a very amazing technology. So I love that technology, guys. So then I would like to go through this manufacturing energy analytics using big data platform. So I think the agenda, I think, seems to be interesting. If it is a seems to be interesting, type interesting in the chat window. Sure. Guys, let me give me a couple of minutes time to explain about a company. The motto of a starting the business. We are the entrepreneurs, myself, my colleagues who are the classmates. We started our business in 5 years back. So we have an aspiration to be entrepreneur. We started this organization. So the vision and mission of this company is to be the world's most loved company. We want to make it. That's our vision. We want to achieve that vision with latest technology and integrating with innovative ideas and design. So, and next will be the mission will be, we would like to sincerely achieve customer delight, enhance our relations with aspiration, innovation and technology. So guys, this is vision and mission of our company, and our journey started in the year of 2014 with a single employee organization. This company started with a zero-based investment, technology as a skill. So we would like to grow this company as a multifold with a global presence, with a world most loved company. That's the journey we are doing. We are emerging with technology. So then after we started our journey, we would like to reach more number of customers already. Few of customers already in the line. So we are working with the different automation industry verticals. We want to be a best customer support in the market to grab the customer attention. And 2018, we developed our own solutions to be partnered with the world best renowned technology companies, and 2019 we are making a footprint in the market. So then after guys, so about this, we do a business in the different verticals. We work in the six industry verticals, where is automation control, where is industrial automation, building automation, home and office hotel automation verticals come into that area, and engineering and execution. We execute the real-time projects on the shop floor level. Industrial solution, we work with National Instruments on data acquisition and 80s development, and we are the pioneers in the industry 4.0 solutions. We work with the Internet of Things products and solutions, and we also work with data analytics. So coming to the core values, these are the core values we believe. And then our business pillars are, so these are business pillars are quality driven, innovation and customer focus and expertise in the particular area. This is our business pillars we are working out. So our achievements are, see, these are the achievements what we achieved till date. I would like to take your permission to showcase our achievements. We have 100 plus happy customers in the across the pan India, 150 plus man years of experience with the mentorship, and 250 plus projects executed till date. Then 25 plus industry verticals taken to the different industry sector. We work in it across the industry verticals. And coming to this recognition, we are the recognized as the best startups in Hyderabad. And then after recently, we recognized as the most trusted industrial automation company in India. That's what our recognition. We, with the support of our customers, we are going to continue this journey. We want to grow with our customers. That's our motto and objective. And coming to the industry 4.0, so I would like to go deep into this terminology of industry 4.0. I will explain about the what is the market is doing. How is, suppose guys, if anybody is buying a product, so they will do at least a simple survey and analysis and point of view. They will ask their peers and they'll ask their colleagues whether I bought this product or whether I purchased this product, what is the benefits and features. So if you are going to take the benefit, if you are going to take your career, if you want to implement industry 4.0 in your shop floor, at least as a business point of view, as an individual point of view, everybody do some analysis on that activity. So I would like to help in this analysis point of view. See this, the market size of industry 4.0 is, so the growing is the market side, which in the 2023, it is going to be $310 billion of what value in the across the world. And it's a CAGR is compound annual growth rate is going to be 37%. So year on year, it's going to be increased at 37% rate. So they're coming to the India market. So we can, you are talking about world. What is about India? So see the how the which industry sectors are contributing more for the GDP growth. These are the real data what I have taken from the sites. You can see the agriculture sector is contributing 15.87% for Indian GDP. And manufacturing sector, the section 2, which is a 29.7%, approximately 30% is contributing for manufacturing sector of GDP. And if you take the service sector, it is contributing 54.4%. So see the $5 trillion economy of Indian going forward, The $1 trillion is for agriculture sector, $1 trillion for the manufacturing and service aligned sectors are $3 trillion which are allotted. So by seeing this contribution of, so this is Industry 4.0 comes into the every area of a business where you can be applied in the agriculture sector, you can able to apply in the manufacturing sector, you can able to apply in the service sector. So this is more driving towards a service oriented, service as the technology solution. So moving back to the trends of Industry 4.0, I will explain about the trends you see. So when you see this, somebody, if you want to know about, everybody goes in the Google, they search about the particular words. So if you see the keyword of Industry 4.0, it was started trending from the year of 2015 in the April. And this is the today market due to this COVID-19. The trend was whittled down. But if you can see this on average, the trend is and a growth factor, the linear fashion, it is growing. So means people are searching, means they need of technology, they have a, they want to know about the technology, they want to use this technology in so that's why they are searching in this. So if you can see this world map, the countries where they're searching, so in the right hand side you can able to see Malaysia in the topmost position, India at the 13th position. So with this current COVID impact, you can see this, the countries which are coming, planning to come out from the China. The China is a global hub for manufacturing, which is almost a $15 trillion of economy. So India still yet is a $2 to $3 trillion and is trying to achieve the $5 trillion economy. So there is an opportunity. The COVID-19 brought in a great opportunity for individual. So and the in the market, in the country like India, they can able to open up the localization, they can bring this they can help out the outside countries to bring the operations and manufacturing in Indian market. So this is going to be play a very key role in the for transformation of technology. Let's come into this Industry 4.0 digital transformation. So this is about the how the technology started and transformation, and today we are in the fourth industrial revolution. Initially, it was started a mechanized production, then it was a mass production, then automation like a computer-based control, then a connectivity. This is smart technologies. So before explaining, I would like to show in a video where you can able to understand this Industry 4.0 and a better point of view. So guys, maybe able to listen the voice of video. So if you are able to listen the voice of video, please type S in the chat window. Okay, sure. I'm playing. Electricity and assembly at the mass production possible. guys, the video is interesting. If it is interesting, please type. Oh, somebody can able to hear, somebody can't hear, but I can't. Maybe it's not a problem from my side. So we can share this video offline, guys. If you want a view offline, you can able to share this video. So if you can view this video, this is a transformation of technology from 3.0 to 4.0, where the industry is changing. So I would like to tell in this few, this entire video shown the demonstration, what is industry 4.0. So I would like to tell about what is the difference from the 3.0 and 4.0. The difference is, so the significant transformation regarding the way we produce the products. So using the digital manufacturing technology, that is the change. So we would like to transform the way we are producing the product using the digital manufacturing technology, that is called Industry 4.0. So I will go in detail. So sometime there may be some discussion was happened, the father of AI. Everybody might have heard the word artificial intelligence. If you hear the word, please type S in the chat window. Please type AI in the chat window. So the AI, the Alarm Tuner, is the father of AI. So somebody came and asked about Alarm Tuner. Mr. Tuner, what you are doing? You are building a machine like a human. You are doing a wrong thing. So then he replied immediately. What he told is, I am making a machine like machine think like a human. That's why. So that's a terminology we are going to understand. We are not going to disrupt any human jobs. This is the technology we want to upgrade yourself to increase the manufacturing productivity, to bring the benefit of value chain in the business. That's the way we are way forwarding journey. So you, at the end of the session, you can able to see what is the value we are going to bring out and what is the job market in this era. So see, this is the industry 4.0 technologies and the market. So how it is going to be impacting, you can able to view. So there are a different technology like a cloud computing and integration systems, simulation software, additive manufacturing, big data, AR, VR, robotics, cyber security, cyber physical systems, and IoT. This is the terminology you can able to see at the outer layer, how these are going to be used in the market. So I am going to give small terminology, guys. Today, this internet, without internet, nobody can't able to live. Without internet, we can't able, we could, it is not, it might not be possible for us to host this type of section. Today, internet is an essential commodity. So internet is an essential commodity in the today market. We don't know whether tomorrow it will come into the stock market for trading as well. And the data is a new oil. It's like an asset in the market. So data is a new oil. If you see this Modi speaking about data is a new oil and gold is talking about new oil. So we can see the transformation happening. The oil company is changed into the data company. So recently there was a $5.7 billion agreement was happened between Facebook and Jio, which is a 9.9% share in the Jio. So which is a worth of 43,574 crores of value. So how we can able to make the value of data, how you apply the methods and terminology like AI, artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning models that will give the returns to you for a business. So I maybe due to insufficient time, I would not go into the in detail in the section. So coming, these are the technologies what is going to be used in the industry 4.0. and coming to this, the McKinsey was given a 12 disruptive technologies for all this Industry 4.0 technologies as a part of 12 disruptive technologies. And I would like to quote a small example over here. So when you see the 12 years back, there was a big recession was happened. The due to the recession, there was a huge technology transformation. The social revolution was started. So every recession brings the change in the technology. Similarly, today we are in the crisis. This crisis will bring the adopt the technology, change yourself to adapt with the new tools and new technology. That's the way we are heading towards. So next, there are the manufacturing opportunity. You can able to see this opportunity in the different area: building control, mining and refining, manufacturing automation, power generation, and the different sectors which are directly or indirectly related to the growth of a country. So coming to this, I will give a small example where we can able to apply this industry 4.0. So guys, if you can see, ladies and gentlemen, if you can see this screen, where the business is a sales which minus operational, the profit in the business is a sales activity minus operational, which is giving the profit value. If you can able to see this section on oil and gas, so there are different countries which are producing the barrel into oil and gas, where the cost of a production, which is $44 for UK and Saudi, is $88. The capital spending means the purchasing cost, which is around $22 for UK, and it's about $3 for oil and gas industry. So Saudi Arabia, sorry. So the production cost is around $17 to the $3 varying, and administration and taxes cost. So if you can able to get the data, if you can apply these methods and technology to reduce the production cost, optimize the operations, and increase the decrease the capital spending, it will be helpful for the change in the not even 0.01% value of the barrel production. It will impact the million and billion dollars of a value. That's a going to be impact going to be happen. So, and then coming to this power sector, so if you can see the power sector, I will take example of Telangana government. So recently Telangana government was given a 10,000 crores of rupees budget for power sector. So the 10,000 crores of rupees, which is an they will use for purchasing the power, distribution, transmission, maintenance, all the activity. So you can see the power purchase cost is 80% of the cost is 88,000 crores are going for power purchase cost. So if you can see this power purchase cost, that is really affecting for government. So we are working on the model where we can able to optimize the power purchase, which can bring the at least 2 to 5% of maybe savings to the government. That's the way that these models like a forecasting analysis will work out. So there is a power purchase cost from 20 rupees to the 17 rupees. So 20 rupees, there was sometimes 17 rupees. Today is in around approximately it's in 4 rupees per unit. So the allocation will has to happen based on the demand. The demand has to be predicted, and the allocation has to happen from the low to the higher level. So these are the these are the technology going to impact for the market. So this is the big impact, and there is a small impact in the bottom level as well. So I would like to touch up with this RAMI architecture. So here, so the RAMI architecture, we will explain about the three dimensions of a industry 4.0. So till date, this is only a one dimension and two dimensional value to the market using automation industry 3.0. Industry 4.0 is targeting in the both the level. When you see this, there are the six layers, which are asset layer, integration layer, communication layer, information layer, function layer, and business layer. It is an IT architecture, so which is in a lifecycle value stream, which has to connect all the softwares at from the bottom to the top level. And there is another architecture, hierarchy level, where it will be connected from product to the connected world, where from the sensor to the field devices, control devices, stations, and workstation, enterprises, and connected world. And there is a third dimension, which is the product lifecycle value. We are going to connect the product's design to the execution and development and the final production quality level. So all, if you combine this, all these three layers, there is a functional view of the three layer, which will going to bring the very good value to the business. That's the RAMI architecture we work out. So there is an attachment just due to only allotted 20 minutes for me. So I'm running out of time. I'm moving to the next section. I'm going to hand over to Suman to take it forward to the next section. Guys, is it interesting till? Do you have any questions? You can type in the chat window.
It was a really very deep insights to the industry from Mr. Gopanna. So I would like to add some little advices to the audience. So just in case if the webinar is suspended, so please make sure to get back with the same link. So as considering the time constraints, we have a lot of knowledge and experience to share, but as time don't permit us for time being, so we are running you out through this quick sessions. So let me quickly introduce Mr. Suman to hold the stage. Yes, Suman. Can you hear me, Suman? Hello, Suman. Am I audible to you? Yeah, please hold on, guys. I think there's a small technical glitch. So I'm just getting in.
Suman, please unmute yourself. You can talk. Unmute yourself and talk. You are unmuted. The voice is not audible to us.
Yeah, now it is okay.
Perfect. Yes, perfect. You can go ahead.
Yeah, fine. Okay. Yeah, sorry. So coming to intro.
Suman, your voice is breaking. Your screen is not shared yet. Suman, are you in line?
Hello, guys. If someone is speaking, then I think I am not able to hear anything. Can just someone check? It's not audible.
Yes, is Ashraful on the mic? Guys, can you please type on the comment box perfect if you can see the screen?
Hello.
Yes, perfect.
Yeah, is it okay?
Yes. Go ahead, Suman.
Yeah. Sorry, I think there is some technical problem. Sure. I think it's some internet problem. Fine, no issue. I just will continue. I just want to discuss about some interoperability challenges and some IT/OT connectivity problem. So let's come into interoperability. The in general terminology, interoperability is, we can discuss about, like, the ability to share and exchange the information using common syntax and semantics to meet application specific functions relationships across a common interface. So this is like ISO 16100 definition. And coming to like another definition, I just tell you, like, one is IEEE definition. So the ability to of two or more systems to components to exchange information and use the information that has to be exchanged. So in normal common terminology, what is interoperability means connectivity between two systems. How we can connect with the two systems. This is the major, this is the interoperability. What are the challenges we are facing when coming connectivity with one system to another system, like one technology to another technology. So this is the normal automation pyramid. So how it will be, like, it is a regular pyramid, what we are using in like industry 3.0, like field devices, PLC components and process controls and manufacturing IT system like MES technologies and enterprise systems. So this is a smart automation device, how it will be, the how we are connecting to cloud systems and all those things. So next, coming to what are the interoperability challenges we are facing. So there are the three interoperability challenges mostly we are facing in our manufacturing. Like, one is like OT to IT, and another one is OT to IIoT and OT to OT. So coming to OT to OT, like, one connectivity between one system to another system, like most of our machines having like a different PLCs and different protocols all these in there. So how to connect with the one protocol to another protocol, and how to connect these systems, like operation technology, so operation technology, that is the one interoperability challenge. And connectivity between OT to IT, that means like machine level to IT level, that means MES level. So how we are connecting OT level to IT level, that means MES level. What are the problems we are facing? what are the problems you are facing? That is like a OT to IT level. And next is like OT to IIoT. So from machine level to we are going to cloud. How data we are sharing from machine level to cloud level? Which are the protocols we are using to machine level to cloud level? This is like a OT to IIoT interoperability challenges. So I just listed out some few of the interoperability challenges most of the people facing in our plant. So first thing is like difficulty with integrating with the data from various technologies, like various to connectivity. So like most of the things, like in our shop floor, like we have the Mitsubishi system, we have a Siemens system, we have a different systems. Every PLC having their own technology, their own protocol. So how to connect between these all protocols? That is the major problem. And next is like lack of knowledge about technologies. So our people most related about the process and parameters and all those things, and how to run the machine, what are the problems we are facing, all that we know about. But most of the people doesn't know about how to connectivity between IT technologies. So from shop floor to IT technology, how to connect, and there is a lack of knowledge, in-house knowledge. And next coming to like data ownership. We are collecting the data, but where we are storing the data, whether it is secure or it is not secure, and what time frequency we are taking the data, and where we are storing. This is the major factor what interoperability challenges we are facing. So guys, like we are in your plant, you are facing same type of interoperability challenges. Please type yes if you are facing same type of interoperability challenges. Yeah, okay, fine. So next we are discussing about IT/OT connectivity. Let's discuss about what is IT/OT, what is OT. It's a operation technology. In operation technology, what are the protocols it involves? Like in operation technology, it is related to most of our machines and all. So it is Modbus, Profibus, Profinet, and all Ethernet. These are different protocols. It's involved in OT technologies. And next coming to IT, it's most related to information technologies, like HTTPs and SMTP servers and XML protocols and all those things will be there. Next coming to IIoT, it's like how we are connecting to cloud. So from machine level to cloud level, how we are connecting, this is most related to industrial Internet of Things. So it is like MQTT protocols and AMQP protocol. It's a different level of protocols it is there. So most like we are a few of the protocols what we are discussing, like in the Internet of Things, like one is IO protocol, is IO link protocol. It is majorly used for Internet of Things to connect between shop level sensors or devices to machine level, I mean IoT level. And next is OT protocol, like it's OPC UA protocol. So it is also useful for connectivity between shop floor devices to. And next is like a IT protocol. It is the MQTT protocol. So it is useful for connect shop floor devices to cloud devices, cloud network. So next we discuss about Industry 4.0 advantages and business benefits. So what are the advantages if you are implementing Industry 4.0? So the major factor is like digitization. So if you are doing digitization, means like automation of all our machines and automation of our all parts. So if you are doing automation of all our components and parts, so you can get advantage, like you can better visible of this whole the plant. So we know the parameters, how it is working, how it is behaving the machine, and all those things we know. So we can better visible the plant system, and we can better predict, we can better assess our things, our machines, and next thing is better, we can go for ERP system. And you can go for analysis also. So we know all data is came. So we can easily analyze the system, and we can easily predict the system. And next is like a business benefits. So in industry, what are the business benefits if you are implementing the Industry 4.0? First First is like the computerization. This is a prerequisite for industry 4.0. This is mostly on industry 3.0, what we are already using. So it is mostly related to automation of our machines and all. So already we are using. And next is like a connectivity. So it is mostly like industry 4.0. So how we are connecting the machines and one machine to another machine, and how we are connecting all protocols and IT, how we are connecting to OT to IT, all those things will be involved. And next is like smart factory. So in smart factory, it will be like visibility and transparency. So what happened, if you are implementing industry 4.0, this connectivity part, so we can easily see like what is happening and what we get in a transparency, like what is happening and what are the problems we are facing in a machine point of view, and what is the production level, and what is that comparison we can make it. And next is like development trajectory. So in development trajectory, like forecasting and adaptability. So we know already like what are the problems we are facing. So how to rectify it and how to optimize solutions, and how same what if you are optimized, so we can adapt the things. And it is like just like a closed loop system. So we can adapt and it will be closed loop system. So automatically your benefits will become. And next year I'm just going for a case study. So I just want to tell you one thing, like we are not disclosing our customer projects or any data. We are not disclosing. It is a confidential data. We are not disclosing any of our customer data. We are just sharing our knowledge and experience, whatever our facing in a problems or what are the things. Yeah. So I'm just sharing these things. Guys, it is make sense what I'm saying. Please type yes if it is make sense.
Yes, yes.
So let's go about case studies. So I'm just going to discuss about one of the project what we have done in automotive industries. That is like digital manufacturing solution. So it is done in automotive industries. This is just like a digitization. In digitization process, we are just data collecting from, data collection is a key aspect. So our team has been executed this project more than 40 number of machines for connectivity of OT to IT level, which includes like CBM, TBM parameters and analysis, all those things. So I just want to share you that what are the challenges we are facing, and what is the project life cycle and all those things I just want to share, and how we are connected and what is the architecture and for individual machine and for plant, how we are connected architecture, all those things I just want to share. So first thing, like challenges what we are the facing. So one is like different IP addresses for different machines. So when we are connecting to the machines to another machine, or we want to share the data. So here this problem will come, like different IP address for different machines, different controllers. So one OEM will put some X IP address, one OEM will put some other X IP address. So when we are connecting at the time, so there is a big issue to change the IP address. And next is like how to connect a basic controller into the network. So few of the controller, they don't have the Ethernet port or some Modbus port. There is just a basic controller. So how to connect this basic controller into a network. And next is like how to connect the sensors into the network. Few of the sensors, it already existed. Few of the parameters we need to take, but how to connect the sense, how to take the parameters and all those things. This is also major critical challenge what we are facing. And what are the data need to be taken, and what frequency we need to take the data. This is also one of the major challenge. So to address all those challenges, we just want to assess we are assessing industry 4.0, like all what are the machines, whether it is compatible for industry 4.0, and if it is not compatible, what are the things need to be do, and whether we need to implement, we need to put a new system, new PLCs or new other controllers we need to put. Like this type of assessment we will do. And what are the we just listed out what are the CBM parameters and what are the important parameters we need to take from the machine. Whether these parameters will be important for the machine, or with these parameters where it will be implemented. And we just study the process. So according to process, we will define the sequences and we will define the cycle of the things. So it will be helpful to implement the Industry 4.0. So guys, is it sense for you? Is it useful for you? Please type if it is useful for you and these type of problems you are facing. Please type yes if you are facing these type of
problems. Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah, fine. So just this is the project life cycle. What we are this is a project life cycle for how to implement the Industry 4.0. So like industry assessment, then next is the basic engineering. And next is like a project ordering and execution, and next is audit and monitoring. This cycle will be continuous. Next, just for easy understanding, I just want to share you one example for easy understanding. For that, I just taken one machine like a washing machine. It is most common for every industries. It may be automotive or it may be other. Also, a washing machine, it may be a common for every industry. So, what are the parameters we are taken from washing machine? That I just want to show you, like some of the CPM parameters we are taken. We just studied the process sequence, and according to the sequence and according to the process, we just listed out the few of the major parameters. It will be affected on machine performance. So one is like a CPM parameters, and this is the condition based parameter. So like temperatures, few temperatures like water pump motor temperature, oil skimmer motor temperature, and pressures like water pressure, oil pressure, and water levels, oil level, and vibration, blower motor vibration, and ROB phase current of the blower motor, and heater currents. So these are the CBM parameters what we are taking. These are major important CBM parameters what we are taking. And there is that EBM parameters like running time, collection running time, coolant running time, and spray motor time, and filter changeover time. These are the few of the TBM parameters what we are listed over here. And next is like a process related parameters, like it's a machine sequence, alarms, and minor stoppages and major stoppages, and number of running cycles, and a number of shift wise and day wise, and machine status, how it is running, what is the running mode, and all those things we are listed out of here. So all these parameters we are taking. So this is the connectivity of our architecture. So how we are taking parameters to monitoring level and analysis level. So first, let me explain about the TBM parameters. So this is already in a machine. If it is not available in a machine, we just develop the program according to the TBM parameters. And it is independent to the machine PLC only. And after that, we just listed out the CBM parameters. So what are the CBM parameters we listed out, and some CBM parameters will be there in a machine, some is not available. So we will install the sensors over here. So some sensors having a 4 to 20 milliamps, some are the RTDs. We need to put some control converters for RTD to 4 to 20 milliamps converters. So this is there in this parameter collection. From this parameter collection, we are just putting one signal converter over here. So we are just converting for our general shop floor technologies for milliamps, 4 to 20 milliamps and all, whatever, maybe the 0 to 10 volts to network protocols. So like it is maybe a Modbus, or it may be a Profibus, or it may be a can open and all those things. So from this controller or PLC, we are just transferring data to master PLC. From this master, we are just collecting all the data into the master PLC over here. So from this master PLC, we are just sending data to the analysis software and monitoring software. Here we are just monitor things, and we just monitor CBM, TBM parameters, and we will analyze the machine performance and number of machines count, product count, and all those things. It depends on the machine, it may be varies. So this is the kind of architecture for individual machine. How it will be there for plant, like it may be 40 machines, it may be 50 machines. How it will be there? So I'm just explaining the plant architecture, how it is there. So this is in a plant architecture, individual machines having individual sensors and individual data sensor level. So from here, we just grouped into these machines. We are grouped into different groups. So depends on the groups, maybe depends on a protocol, similar protocol, or similar parameters, or similar machines. That depends on the machines, we will group it out. So all these group machines, we are just collecting a data into the one group controller, into like a 5 machines or 7 machines, depends on a data rate and frequency rate. We are just group the machines. This may be like a we are just grouping the machines and we are collecting data from IO link or Modbus or general our 4 to 20 milliamps and all those things. So from this group controller, we are just putting a central controller over here. With this group controller, we are just taking a data to central controller on Profibus, Profinet, Ethernet protocols. From this, here we are going for analysis software. This is a machine level software. Here we can analyze the system, and here we can optimize the system optimization, and here we can maintain the our preventive maintenance checklist. Also here we can maintain, we can see how machine performance is there and how to optimize the things and all those things we can take here. From here to here, this is the OPC-UA connectivity, and from here to here, like, this is the big data analytics and predictive maintenance and forecasting. This is a major factor. Here we are just connecting over. This is this where here this dumped into the database. From database, we can take into the big data analytics. So this is the major plant architecture. Guys, it is useful. Please type yes if it is same type of things you are facing a problem or same type of things you are doing it. Please type yes. If it is useful, please type yes. So next is like a machine, how we are taking a data and all those things. I'm just showing you the our screenshots, some of the screenshots what I'm showing. This is the individual machine, how we are taking a data, and what are the data we are taking, how we are taking. This is the Siemens PLC, what we are used. So Siemens high level PLC, what we are used over here. And next is like multiple data, how we are taking multiple machines data, how we are taking and how we have segregated these things, all those things here. And next is like a end-to-end like a CBS system, so security level. So after seeing this whole architecture, we just know about that what is about the security. So what will happen if your data is stolen somebody and all those things. So these things will be coming to the picture. So in security point of view, like, we need to do some critical measures, and we need to do some firewalls over here. We done like manage switches over here from PLC to connectivity levels. Up to PLC, it is a shop floor device, so there is no data stolen and all those things will be happening. When we are transferring data from PLC to the network level, there may be a data issues will become. So here we are putting one, we can put unmanaged managed switches over here, and from here we can put a firewalls over here. So it will be useful to security. So next, I'm just want to discuss about what are the impacts and what are the added values to the customer if you are implementing Industry 4.0. So one thing is like making existing systems smarter. So anyways, we are just putting a machine, all like we are taking data from the machine and we are optimizing the system and we are putting sensors to the system. So obviously it will be a smarter system, and it will be an add-on factor for the machine. So next is like a increase efficiency and productivity. Efficiency can be boost, efficiency and productivity can be boost. Why? Because we are already just connected and we are just analyzing the system, how machine behavior and all. So we can easily improve the efficiency of the system. And next is like a downtime. So we can reduce the machine downtime easily. So like maintenance planning depends on some parameters. Okay, some motor will be damaged frequently, or there is a problem in a motor, or there is a more vibration is coming into the motor. That's what. So in future, there is a damage of a motor, or it is going beyond the temperature levels, or it is going beyond the current levels. So there may, in future, there is a problem. So before only we can maintain the system, and we can maintain the, we can reduce the maintenance cost as well. And we can increase the uptime and availability of the machine as well. So next, coming to the like a process optimization. Anyways, this will be done with Industry 4.0. So we know we can optimize the process. Like we know all the parameters. So by using all these parameters, we can optimize the process. So next is like I just want to share you a lot of information. I have a lot of information. regarding in the industry 4.0, like OE calculations, how you done, and machine connectivity and all those things. But time is not permitting to me. So I'm just handovering to our guest, Mr. Nikhil from Phoenix. He just explained about most of the projects in Industry 4.0 and good products in Industry 4.0.
Yes, Suman, it was really an in-depth industry analysis. And so far, thanks for holding with us, people. So this is not done yet. So till now, if you felt the information is worthwhile, please type powerful on the chat box. Come on, guys, please comment, because that keeps us motivating and so that we can share some distinctive knowledge on this platform. So I would take this opportunity to invite our next speaker, Mr. Nikhil. So he is a business unit automation systems engineer. So I would like to hold the stage, Nikhil.
Thank you.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. Please carry on. Yeah.
Once again, good evening all. So myself, Nikhil, from Phoenix Contact. So we'll start with the presentation. I hope my PPT is visible. I hope my PPT and sound is visible. So we'll start with the presentation. So once again, when we are going deep into the details, we'll be having a brief introduction about what is Phoenix Contact. So Phoenix Contact is almost 100 years old company. So we are specializing in automation products and solutions. So I have my PPT and voice is audible.
So yes.
Okay. Perfect, Nikhil. You can.
Yeah. So we will talk why this PLC Next technology from Phoenix Contact is required in the day-to-day applications.
Nikhil, sorry to interrupt. You have a 15-minute slot. Sorry to interrupt because we have a lot to cover another case study.
Okay. I will do that. I'll plan it that way.
Sure.
Yeah. So this is actually, in fact, PLC Next technology is one technology which is a patented technology by Phoenix Contact. So you know that in this changing world, when things are more network closer and when more information is exchanged, there is a fundamental shift happening from the classic system structures. So that's why we have come up with this technology called a PLC Next technology. So what is a control system technology previously is that you have vendor dependency and supply centric approach, field communications, and also the transfer of communications or the projects was not possible. And it was in fact a closed loops kind of approach to the classic PLCs. So in fact, we came up with a more friendly approach with the changing market and our customer requirement that things are to be linked together from various vendors, things are to be plugged together, and it can serve as a cloud-based business model. And it will help in predictive maintenance.
Mr. Nikhil, sorry to interrupt. Your voice is fluctuating. Amplitude is varying up and down. I think you are going away from the mic sometimes.
Okay. I'll take care of that.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. And the cyber security.